دكتور ابو واحد فين؟ دكتور ابو واحد عارف والعميد رئيس الجامعة مشي؟ انا بسألك لان انا زميلك في الميديا فبسألك انت مش فاهم.
That shields underlying problems from external insults. But at the same time, we will find that cellular components must remain dynamic to allow tissue regeneration and response to cutaneous insults. How does this occur? By this type of cells. The molecular biology of tumors takes this in which the cells perform. We will find that in the basal cell layer, the keratinocytes are proliferating, and then they start differentiation in the upper layers, which are stratospinosum and stratum granulosum, and this differentiation is a very special type of differentiation in which the cells perform specific activities which are not found in most of the cells of the body. Then, at the top, we will find that the cells are forming five in order to protect the surface and make it protected from other things. Not only that, but we will find that these cells actually start to disquamate. Disquamate means it will take everything which is not or which is maybe dangerous to the body, and take them and give them away from the body. Actually, this cell is marvelous to everything, as we will see from the molecular biology of it. Now, if we take the proliferation, we will find that the stem cells which start the formation of the epidermis rests on the basement membrane, and actually there are certain proteins which are very important in these cells, like the keratin, the molecules of the histone, and the more important is the alpha-1 integrin. These cells synthesize the basement membrane and the ECM or extracellular matrix under it. There is a center between the dermal cells and the epidermis, and in order to perform the whole function. Maybe you don't have time to talk about that, but we have to imagine that there is a center between the dermis and epidermis. This center goes through certain molecules which are found in the basal part of the cell, and these molecules include the integrins, which are alpha and beta integrins, and the receptors like the EGFR. Now, we'll find that this proliferation is controlled by specific genes. Let's go to these genes and look what happens. Now we find that in the membrane of the cell, we have the cell membrane, cell nucleus, cytoplasm, and the genome. On the membrane, we said that we have receptors and the integrins. Now the integrins act on the receptors in order to activate it. Then there are certain molecules within the cytoplasm which activate the transcription factors needed for the activation of the genes that will produce the products and perform the activities. The products here are actually begin by P63 and of course the cyclins, and the cyclins now act on the genes specific for the formation of the proteins for the DNA replication, and so these molecules will be found in the cytoplasm for replication. Let's look at the is very interesting in these cells. Let's look at replication and take the part of the genome, which we call telomere. And if we look
cells pose unique problems during DNA replication.
Division we will find that two important things happen. One of them is that while the vision here is horizontal and parallel to the basement membrane, we will find that the molecules, there are molecules which will be forming, and these molecules which will be forming will start differentiation. The whole process of differentiation is found in a cluster of genes which are beside each other exactly the same way the differentiation is needed, and this cluster of genes is found on the one arm of chromosome number 1 in region 22. This cluster of genes produces in the spinous layer, the transglutaminase, as you will see, the granular layer of keratin 1 and 10 instead of 5 and 15 which we had, proflagelline transglutaminase. And in the strata cornea, it forms fluorescein, ornithine, and S114, and these are the gene expression which is needed for differentiation. Of course, we can follow that by immunohistochemical reactions, and we can see that. At this, in this cell, we will find that there are proteins that are forming at the pole of the cell, which orients the mitotic spindle. Instead of being horizontal, it becomes vertical. Okay? And not only that, but the E63 gene, when it's downregulated, we will find that the Notch gene starts to be activated. And the Notch gene is the gene which controls the process of differentiation in these cells. So we'll find that the spindle will be vertical instead of horizontal, and so we will have the cells which are found in the upper or in the spinous layer. These cells are so different from all other types of cells. All the cells of the body, when they differentiate, they stop in what we call the GO phase. The GO phase contains one set of genome. But in this case, in this cell, we will find that the cell cycle will continue in it. But P21, which is activated by Notch, stops it in the G2 phase. What do we mean by that? We mean by that that we will have a larger cell in order to perform the functions needed for differentiation, and two sets of genes instead of one set. Why? In order to give more and more and more gene activities. Instead of having the gene giving just one activity, it will be duplicated. Okay? And so this is a kind of cell which is not found in most of the differentiating cells in our body. Now, these cells become large, containing two sets of genomes, and they start to form what makes the epidermis stable. What makes the epidermis stable are the different, as we said, that there is genomic redundancy, which appears as a large number of nucleoli. That large number of nucleoli means that there is gene redundancy, number one. Number two, that there is activity in production of proteins. Now, we'll find that we have different structures which connect the cells together, makes them adherent in order to be stable, okay, and cannot be sloughed under the conditions of the environment. For example, we have desmosomes, and let's look at one thing. This is false. We'll find that the cytoplasmic cytoskeleton, which are the keratin fibers, are attached to the desmosomes in these cells and to the desmosomes in the other cell. And so you can imagine that the whole epidermal cells are attached together as one unit by these keratinocytes through the desmosomes. Not only that, but these actually function in activating the genes and as well for giving the calcium. The calcium is very important in the differentiation of keratinocytes because it's very important in formation of all the functions which we will see later. The second type is also the adherent junction, which perform the same thing, and you will see the cytoskeletal elements connected together as well as calcium, which is found in here. The gap junction, in order to give the information molecules from one cell to the other, so that all the cells will share the information from each other. In the upper layer, which is the granular layer, it is exposed to the surface. So there will be a special junction which prevents the passage of water through it. And this junction is the tight junction which prevents the passing of water from the inside to the outside or vice versa, and so keep the body from dehydration. If we look to the keratinocyte terminal differentiation, we will find that in the terminal differentiation, the keratin fibers are formed in order with the different junctions to keep the cells together in here. But after that, we will see that the cell prepares for death, for apoptosis. And we know that apoptosis in any cell means that the loss of the activity of this cell, except this cell. This cell actually tries to protect us. And so the death of these cells actually is a functional aspect in order to give protection to our body. If we take the first thing which is formed in the gelatino island granules, and we will see what is the importance of keratinohyaline granules later. This keratinohyaline granules is forming in the cytoplasm, okay, and so, and it is conserved in the cytoplasm. Sorry, معلش سمحني اني هاخد شوية زيادة في الوقت الان بتاع سلوك بالك هنا سلوك معلش الان the second thing is that instead of having cell membrane, which can be can move phase between it, a cell, a cell that membrane will have a structure which makes it cornified, the cornified membrane, as we will see. Then the third thing is that important thing in the differentiation, and that is the lamellar bodies. The lamellar bodies are forming as vesicles, but these vesicles contain two things. The first is lipids in order to protect the cells or the intercellular substance from moving of water from inside to the outside, and the lysosomal enzymes which will help later on. Now, we'll see that these molecules will be arranged, or these vesicles will be released to the intercellular space, and so it will form the, in the intercellular space, they will form a kind of insulation between cells, but in the same time they have so many things. I'll tell you about two things, just two things. One of them is an enzyme which is important for digestion of the in between cells, so that the cells, the chlorophyte cells on the top, can be released. The second thing is that it has ATP pump, hydrogen pump, in order to make the skin pH 5.5 acidic. And this acidity is very important for the functioning of the epidermis. Now, prolonged cell death and chromatification, and I think this is the last thing, we'll find that here the keratinohyaline granules will be digested and accumulate the keratin fibers in order to form the soft keratin. But at the same time, we find that all the organelles of the cells will be digested by the lysosome. So this is a kind of apoptosis, but a very special type of apoptosis. Now, keratinohyaline granules together with the keratin fibers will form the soft keratin, which is capable of binding about 30% of its weight of water, and so keeps the upper layer hydrated or with water. Now, we see that at last we will come to here, this enzyme will digest the intercellular substance and helps the formation of the final dead keratinocyte or the chromosome. So this is the way a keratinocyte protects our body. I'm sorry, I have keyed time, but I didn't keep time. I'm sorry for that, but this what happens, and so we can say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Hada aruni maga khalqa al-Ladina
microphone to my colleague, Professor Ibrahim Hassan.
ونهنيكم على انكم عملتم الخطوة.
Yeah, this is the logic expression. You see, there's a
understand the word classification. I should take example of the classifications of addicts and tumors. Here, the success that makes it happen, right? And the term is the most important. And then, point to that, the radical, came as a result of polluted, obtuse, misleading, incorrect, impenetrable, nervous system. And the first one, should take example. Then, is a subject of pathology of addicts and tumors. Hey, let's have some kind of information. And two examples, de-intoxication affects the humans, same, and two, which all of them are part of the type of lesion, the vitamin and the tumors, the tumors, or the blood pathology, and the very equals of the tumor. Can you want to go to the tumor? I tell you, who can you define it to the humans? Who can you define it to the humans? لو بصينا هنا الاول حاجه كونفوزنج هل هكذا ليز ايكوالز هو كوم او ايكوالز اللي هو كاس كوم هيتحط في مجموعه تيرالي هنيجي للقصه الثانيه او الجروب الثاني بيلاين في اليوم في اليوم كلمه في اليوم فرنش ديسكاسيون فكان يعني ازاي ده يقول بيلاين في اليوم او بيلاين في اليوم فدي برضه سمثينج فيري كونفوزنج بعد كده
Big, dark, sneaky, or the opposite.
طيب هو where هتعمل ايه؟ what's next؟ we have to be in the steward اللي بيحصل ان the pathologist wrote a common case to the pages of the modern standard textbook of the microphone hoping to happen upon the histologic picture that examines the perplexing one from another microscope اللي بيحصل حتى دلوقتي الاول يعني له سلايد يعني didn't arrive at the diagnosis يحتاج يألف الكتاب على اساس ان هي صوره تشبه الليجن اللي هو على الميكروسكوب but usually the cancer research comes in is usually fruitless. غالبا مش بيقدر الواحد يوصل يعني لا تيومر ما وصلش ولا حاجه فيبتدي يألف الكتاب يوصل عشان يوصل الصوره تشبه الكتاب الصوره على الميكروسكوب فغالبا usually is fruitless. طيب يبقى الحل ايه؟ هو دي مع البيكسل تيومرز هو الوان تو اثويتس. نمبر 1 ديسايد ويذر النيوكلاسيك از ديفايد ليكويد and the second is to consider the proliferations from the vantage of the differentiation. يعني اول مش تشوف is it right or the liquid and then to determine its level of differentiation. شوف الاول the first point to decide whether the tumor or the neoplasm is benign or malignant.
اشتغلت عليها.
النقطة اللي بعد كده بلانش واز يوجوالي ذيس ابوت ستور اوف ميد تشيلدرن ايلاندز وايل ان ليجل تشيلدرنز بيكوز ذير از ريد بوسز مور لاجريجيس اوف ايلاندز. وهنا طبعا زي ما حضرتك هنا في كيف اللي هو كان ستور النقطة دي برضه مهمة قوي.
Thank you.
qualities you like about him. Charles is his leg, his vision, and his vertical ability. This duo, legacy.
You just give us
what can it be? Minus sinus is like this, and minus is natural. Minus sinus does not mean that the proximity is a specific diagnosis of the intestines, which is based on the differentiation. We have to do the primary proximity. The minus sinus is a non-stroke thing, and the next and tumors, which we said, the diagnosis. And sometimes you can do panel score, she takes out tumors like this, and make them see over, but they are not really. The borderline behind the malignant sometimes is not very sharp, and you have a little system, then in the left, actually, the healing, and then the stages of the transformation, you can pass through several stages. And so sometimes the differentiation between the right and the malignant is not so sharp.
And this is the case of cysts derived from the sebaceous, but all cysts.
yesterday. And so, you can identify the system to be a sufficient source of his life water, and that's where it's in him, and in his world where there is a sufficient source. This is sufficient differentiation.
اعتقد كده الساعة ما تعدت
person to build the robot was
Thank you.